What's up, guys? It's BRT, back with another Day 1 build guide. In today's guide, we're going to be reviewing the Void Hunter. The Void Hunter is a very strong support subclass focused on debuffing enemies and providing your team with invisibility. So without further ado, let's get right into this build. Alright, starting off with the weapons for today's build, we got the Raconteur Bow. This bow is just amazing. It really, truly excels in ad clear. It does so much damage, it melts yellow bars, and it one-shots all red bars in the game. This thing just does so much ad clear, and you will never be running into an issue with survivability while you have this weapon equipped. Personally, I always take this weapon with me into raids for my primary ad clear weapon. This weapon just excels in everything it does. It's just amazing. The next weapon we got today is the Ruinous Effigy Exotic Trace Rifle. Now this Void weapon will pair perfectly with our Void build. And this exotic perk is called Transmutation. Killing enemies with this weapon will spawn a Void Orb on the ground, which then you can pick up to do some fun stuff with. One of the things you can do with it is a heavy attack where you slam it on enemies and deal massive damage to them. It one-shots pretty much all red and orange bars in the game, and it's really good for ad clear. The next thing it can do is you can use a block with it, which reduces damage for anyone inside the big force field it creates, as well as damaging and blinding and suppressing enemies that dare step inside that dome to challenge you. And it will also deal massive damage to them and could kill even red bars. Now, for the heavy weapon, we got the age-old classic, the Taipan 4FR Linear Fusion Rifle. Now, this rifle fires a charged beam that deals so much damage to enemies. It destroys champions, bosses, and everything in between. This gun can deal upwards of 400,000 damage a shot. It is just insane. And you're always going to be hitting top DPS in your fire team while you have this weapon. This is actually craftable as well, and the rolls I recommend on it is Triple Tap and Frenzy. Triple Tap gives you ammo back when you hit 3 precision hits in a row, and Frenzy gives you a 15% damage boost when you're in combat with enemies, which is really good for boss DPS, and you're just going to destroy any day one boss with this weapon. Alright, going into the subclass right now, starting off strong, we have the Spectral Blade Super. This super is amazing. You get two attacks, a light attack and a heavy. The light attack is going to do some quick damage to adds, while the heavy attack is going to weaken the target in front of you, and you're going to go back invisible, further helping you with that survivability. Going on to our abilities, we have the Marksman Dodge. This dodge is actually better because it has a 9-second shorter cooldown than this Gambler's Dodge. So you're going to be able to go invisible even more with this Vanishing Step aspect that makes dodges make you invisible. Moving on to the jump, I always recommend the high jump. These jumps just don't nearly get it done when you want the extra height, so that's why the high jump is the better jump. For the melee, the Hunter only has access to one melee, and that is the Snare Bomb. While this melee isn't very good on its own, with this aspect to the Trapper's Ambush, activating your melee is going to make you and nearby allies invisible, giving you guys extra survivability for your entire team, which is just perfect for the support subclass. Moving on to the grenades, I highly recommend you run the Axion Bolts. These grenades, when you throw them, they're going to shoot out some bolts that track to nearby enemies and just do massive detonating damage. Moving on to the fragments, we have the Echo of Dilation. When you're crouched, you actually sneak faster, and it gives you 10 mobility and 10 intellect, giving you even more dodges and even more supers. The next one we have, Void Final Abilities, cause targets to explode. And as you can see, this one also gives you 10 intellect, tying in perfectly to the super. Every single kill you get with the super, everything's going to explode. It's perfect for ad clear. It's just incredible. The next one we got is the Echo of Undermining. It's going to make your void grenades apply weaken to the targets it hits. So every time you throw on this Axion Bolt on the ground, it's going to track to enemies, weaken them, and do massive, massive damage. Last fragment we have here is the Echo of Vigilance. This is my personal favorite. when you have no shields, so you just have that red bar of HP, killing an enemy is going to give you a temporary void overshield. I think it's about 65 HP or something insane like that. It's just going to really help with survivability. You will never, never die while you have this fragment equipped. It is just amazing. Alright, finishing this build, we have the 6th Coyote Exotic Chest Armor. This chest armor gives you a second dodge charge. It is probably one of the best hunter exotics in the game currently. Going on to the mods, we have a Harmonic Siphon. This is going to generate some orbs of power when we get kills with our void weapons. And then we also have 2 dynamos. These are going to give us super energy when we dodge near enemies, which ties in perfectly with the second dodge charge we're going to get with a 6th Coyote. We're just going to be dodging near so many enemies and having so much super from these mods. On our arms, we got a Void Loader and a Void Dexterity. This is just going to make our void weapons feel so much better to use. Just give us extra reload and more handling when swapping between weapons. It's just going to make your void weapons feel so, so much better. We also got a Grenade Kickstart. All the orbs we're going to be making from our void weapons is going to give us this Grenade Kickstart. So when we throw a grenade, we're going to get a little bit of that grenade energy back, allowing us just to have our grenade up more readily, which is just going to help again with the ad clear. On our chest piece, we have a Unflinching Void Aim. This is going to be perfect for the Taipan. When the boss is shooting at you during DPS phase, your gun is not moving off this head. You're going to get so much more DPS and so many more precision hits with this. You're going to be out damaging your fire team, and they're going to be asking you, hey, what are you using for DPS? I want to use the same thing. And you're going to tell them it's the Taipan with the Unflinching Void Aim. The next thing we got are 2 Lucent Blades. This is going to be perfect for Spectral Blades. It's going to give us more charge time on those Spectral Blades, allowing for double the uptime, giving us more ad clear and even more boss DPS. It's just so perfect. Onto our legs, we have an Insulation and a Recuperation. Picking up orbs is going to give us class ability and health, respectively. So dodging, you're going to have more of those up. You're going to get some HP from the orbs. It's going to be amazing. And then we have a Void Scavenger to give us more ammo back on our void weapons when we pick up ammo bricks. Finally, on our class item, we have 2 Reaper mods. These Reaper mods, when you dodge, the next kill you get gives you orbs of power, which give you even more dodges and some HP, which is just going to keep looping your dodges, giving you more invisibility and more survivability. This build is just so unstoppable. You're never going to die on this. It is just amazing. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe for more epic build videos. And as always, leave a comment letting me know what you think of this build and how well it works for you. The build link for DIM is going to be in the description of the video, so make sure to check it out if you want to use this build. Thank you for watching. BRT out.